stop! I feel like a glass shrimp in a big panty with a saccharin chaperone. Make invalids out of Superman. Call in a...
Well, this guitar here that I made is called a diddly bow, and it's a one-string slide blues guitar. And these kind of instruments would be made in America in the early 20th century. And it's just basically one string with a tightener. And this is a tuner tin here. And you can play... Yeah, I made this myself. It's made out of mahogany and in two pieces glued together. And you can make them any shape you want, really. I think I made this about 2 years ago. And I've made about four or five different ones. I've got one with two strings, like a double neck one in a kind of 90s, 70s shape. And another one which is made out of part of a tree, which has got like a long branch coming out here. So it can be any shape you like, really. I just sort of build these things out of my own curiosity, really. And you get ideas, you know, and you just want to sort of follow them and make things. And you can kind of, I've always made lots of different stuff. I mean, as an artist, a painter, writing and drawing and stuff, and I also like to build things out of wood, so I guess I'll build anything that I can think of doing, really.
When he was very young, I should think possibly about five or six,
mm-hmm,
about that sort of age, he was always keen on constructing things, making things, and he used to specialise when he was about five, six, seven, eight or something like that, making very small paper models of cars mainly, of different types, and colouring them all in, and cutting them out of a complete piece
flat
of paper.
Flat piece of paper.
So he's making a development, a complete open development, and that was all in his head. I was really amazed at the way in which he could think of how to make a shape,
a three-dimensional
article from a flat sheet of paper, you know, cutting it out and constructing it and making it with separate pieces, joining them all together. Then the thing was looked exactly as it should.
I'm a mummy. I scare people. Watch what happens when I walk up to somebody. I'm a mummy.
Ramsey's worked very hard on it to try and get all the angles right, because there aren't any square angles, really. Everything is a slope, and when you see it on the road, actually, it looks good because it's moving, and you can get a look all the way around it. But today the weather isn't so good, so it's too windy to take out. The wings would fall off. Yeah, because I didn't quite know what he was doing to begin with, because he had it all in his head. But once he'd started, and the thing started taking shape, and he was copying, making a reduced size of what the stealth bomber looks like. It's only like a cartoon of a stealth bomber, really. This is the actual stealth bomber, you see.
Yeah, very different.
Very different. So this is all compact.
But generally the shapes are the same, like the back pieces I've got on there. And it's all, you know, flat shapes. That's the thing why I realised I could make it, because everything in this aircraft is all flat shapes. This is a bit more complicated, though. There's a lot more angles and things going on. But in a way, it's quite a simple shape, so I wanted to do a version of it like that. And I found this bike about 5 years ago, And that was what gave me the idea, sort of like, what could I make on this bike, you know? And then wanted to make one of these. So this needs a few more months, or another month or something to finish, really. It's not strong enough, you know. I need to reinforce the parts so that it fits together much easier. Because that's the other thing, it's so big, I've got nowhere to store it as it is. Mm-hmm. So I've made it so everything comes apart. But then you have to do all these fixtures.
Yeah,
so you can put it together, screw it together, and then take it apart, you know. Yeah. Serious. My sort of very woodland version, which is just basically a branch from a tree, and I wanted with a strangely shaped violin bass there and an ordinary tin can. And this one's pretty good if you put it through an amp here, which I've got, and hopefully we're going to get this working and get some incredible sound out of it. Let's see.
Gonna make love, not war, not war. Gonna make love, not war.